One of the more commonly asked questions we get in our business is how to identify fire hose threads. Now, the nominal size is one thing, but there are literally dozens of fire hose threads in the market today. This short tutorial will help you identify the proper fire hose thread for your application. Throughout the presentation, we will be referring to charts and data that are found in the back of all of our catalogs under technical information. The thread dimension chart shows the dimensions of the various fire hose threads that we will be referring to later. Also important is the thread chart seen here. This chart represents the more common threads we'll encounter in the fire industry. Finally, we have the thread compatibility chart shown here. This is useful in defining the acronyms such as NST as National Standard Thread, explaining the compatibility of the male and female ends, as well as listing if the seal is a mechanical seal or a washer seal. Keep these charts in mind when we look at how to gather this information from the sample we have in front of us. Dixon marks all of our products with our part number, makes this next process much easier. However, if you happen to have an unmarked product, we'll need to identify the threads per inch, or TPI, the ODM, the maximum dimension of the outside diameter. We'll also need to know if we're looking at a straight thread or a tapered thread. Tapered threads are more difficult to measure in that the threads taper, whereas straight threads are much easier. Good for us, most fire hose threads are straight thread. One of the easiest ways to identify the TPI is with a thread pitch indicator. Each slat will have a predetermined number of peaks on it to help you identify the fire hose thread. The way you know you have a match is when the peaks and valleys mate like a perfect union. To identify the TPI and ODM, let's take an assessment of the tools we have at our disposal. Let's assume we have a ruler, a piece of paper, and a sharp implement, the bare minimum needed to measure the outside diameter. What we'll do is we'll take a piece of paper about 11.5 to 18 inches long, and we will wrap it around the circumference of the fitting until we get a tight overlap. We'll then take the sharp implement and we will poke it through, making sure we pierce both sides of the paper. Mark your pinholes so that you can clearly see them. Take a ruler and measure the distance between the two points. Divide by 3.1416 and you will have the outside diameter of the thread. Now to find the TPI, we'll take the same piece of paper. We will push roughly against the threads. The idea here being that we will make an impression of the threads per inch, where again, we can measure. In this instance, I have 4 threads and 1/2 inch or 8 threads per inch. For this next scenario, let's assume that we have a caliper, an OD tape, and a piece of paper, one or the other on this. A caliper works when you measure from the widest point on the fitting, peak to peak at the widest point. Outside diameter tape works, as you might imagine, as a tape measure around the outside diameter. Again, to find the threads per inch, we'll make an indention on a piece of paper, and we will then measure how many threads per inch. To measure the ODM using the caliper, make sure you measure the distance from peak of thread to peak of thread across the largest number of whole threads. When measuring the female, you'll need the caliper or the ruler to measure the internal dimension of the female, again, measuring from peak to peak at the widest point. Now that you have your data, refer back to the thread dimension chart shown here. We know the ODM is 3.03 and the TPI is 8. Judging by the information here, we are looking at a 2.5-inch New York Fire Department thread. If you have any doubts, any questions at all, please feel free to contact Dixon directly or visit our website. We look forward to helping you make the right connection.